But what if you do have one chiral center, which happens all the time, okay? Well, if you have the same chiral center on both, then they're identical, okay? If you have different chiral centers for both, then the relationship is going to be enantiomers, okay? And let me illustrate this with the following molecules. Let's say that I have 2-butanol, and I have another 2-butanol, okay? So I've already verified that these two compounds have the same molecular formula, they have the same IHD, everything, and they have the same connectivity. They're both secondary alcohols that are butanols, all right? So then I go ahead and I figure out the configuration of this, and I figure out that this one is R, has one chiral center, and this one is also R. So what do you think that relationship is? Well, that's going to be identical, okay? Because they're the same molecule and they have the same chiral center, okay? Now, what if I'm comparing it to, instead of R, what if I were comparing it to the same molecule, but now my OH is on a dash, okay? Now, instead of being R, this one's going to be S, okay? What do you think is the relationship between these two guys, okay? Well, we have one chiral center, and they're different. So then these would be enantiomers, or mirror images. Does that make sense? That's the way this flowchart works. Basically, we look step by step and we say, are they the same? Are they different? Etc.